Giants are terrible. They gave up 51 points in a loss on Sunday to the Rams. Now ESPN quoted two anonymous Giants who ripped their head coach, Ben McAdoo. One of these anonymous Giants says McAdoo has lost his team. He's got us going 80% on Saturdays before we get on a plane to play a game. It's wild. Change our off day. He's dishing out fines like crazy. Suspended two of our stars when we needed them most. Throws us under the bus all the time. He's ran us into the ground, and people wonder why we've been getting got. We're joined by Fox NFL insider Jay Glazer.
If ESPN said it, it's got to be true, right? Change the 80% to something else then.
Okay. What are you hearing in New York?
No, look, here's the thing. Ben McAdoo, a year ago, when he first came in there, all these players were like, you know, we thought he'd have a hard time commanding the room, but, man, he doesn't. It's really, it's changed everything from Tom Coughlin. We're so relaxed with this guy. He commands the room, and all of a sudden, a year later, because some of the personnel moves they've made haven't worked out, now all of a sudden, he's changed. You don't suddenly overnight become a dumb coach.
Right.
It doesn't happen. Right. You don't go from one year like, oh, this guy's a smart coach one year, and the next year, he just, you know, got hit in the head 9,000 times. Mm. So I think more than anything, you got to look at a lot of personnel decisions in there. You got to look, starting with Jerry Reese, the general manager, the people he brings in there. You still got to bring people in you know are going to fit together. And he hasn't done that. And it didn't really address the offensive line, which they really knew was the biggest problem over there. And whenever things are going bad, I could find two anonymous sources to say anything I want about any team out there, anything at all. Mm. It's real easy. Now, are they imploding? Yeah. It's, you know, it's
bad, huh?
It's bad because here's the thing. Even in the worst of times, the worst the Giants have ever been, they had a quarterback named Dave Brown. And it was a horrible offensive defense versus, you know, offense versus defense rift. Awful. I mean, it was like, it was the Hatfields and the McCoys. It was really bad. And even at that time, guys weren't getting suspended for leaving. Guys weren't getting ticked to the coach and walking out. Like, even at that time, it wasn't this bad where, yeah, it's there's anarchy going over there. And you got one guy over there kind of bringing everybody together, and that's Justin Pugh. And, you know, you have a guard who's the one guy that maybe they'll listen to. They need more than that.
Yep.
I'm not surprised to hear this because there were high expectations. A lot of people had picked the Giants to represent the NFC in the Super Bowl.
Sure.
And anytime you have high expectations and those expectations aren't met, there's going to be some frustration. Offensively, they have not underperformed. Mm-hmm. As you mentioned, Jay, the offensive line has been terrible. Odell is out for the entire season. Brandon Marshall wasn't playing well even before he got injured and now is out for the season.
Yep.
Defensively has been the biggest underperformer. Mm-hmm. Considering what they were last year and what they are this year, they've made no significant changes. And they didn't need to, but there's no reason for them to fall off and be like they are this year. For me, Skip, I've gone through a situation like this, and let me tell you how what happens, is that once things start to go bad, the first thing, well, the coach, he fined me. And see, here's the problem. Players like consistency. If I was late for a meeting last year when we were winning and you didn't find me, don't find me now, because the reason why we're not winning isn't because I'm late. Because the reason why we're losing was because I'm late. Because when we was winning, I was showing up late and you didn't have a problem with it. Guys like consistency. But here's the thing. If guys don't believe in him, or they only, because remember, he came on, they only saw him as an offensive coordinator. It's hard to have that kind of transition there.
But he did it last year.
I know.
They looked at him last year like that. So they got the respect last year. Those guys got to look inside themselves.
That's the way I judged it, Skip. For me, anytime a coach got fired on my watch, Shannon Sharpe didn't do his job.
Yeah.
Not enough people think like that. It's him. He called some bad plays. He doesn't know how to manage a team. I think guys need to look at themselves. Why is this guy on the hot seat? Clearly. Because last year he was on the hot seat, but I said at the beginning of the year, with the expectations they have, Jay, if they don't make the playoffs, I don't believe he's not keeping this job.
I think the place is so messy right now. But again, the one thing, we're not talking about Jerry Reese, right?
Oh, yeah.
You got to build that team from within. And draft pick wise, there was a period there a few years ago, and it went on for a few years, where they were the worst drafting team in the NFL. Mm-hmm. And when he fired Tom Coughlin last year, when they moved him on, whatever you want to call it, he came out and really, I mentioned about the draft picks, and he got very defensive. Says, what proof is there? What proof is there?
We're looking
it's called Google. It was just invented, you know? I mean, what proof is there? And they're not able to build that foundation with all these players. They don't have 9-year vets over there and 8-year and 10-year vets that you could really build a great team around. Has he done better in the last couple of years with Odell Beckhams of the world? Yeah,
Landon Collins.
Absolutely, right? Landon Collins. But, man, they have whiffed so much, and they weren't – even the draft picks they have in the last few years certainly weren't good enough to
Eric
build
Flowers.
This great fan foundation.
Mm-hmm. Yep. For the record, yesterday, Landon Collins and DRC did publicly defend McAdoo. Mm-hmm. So just – that was public.
And DRC was suspended by one Ben McAdoo, so that says something.
And for the record, Jerry Reese, about 2 weeks ago, did publicly take all – he said, blame me for all this. So he did.
That's about 5 years too late, though.
I got you. But at least he saw the handwriting and finally said, right. I can't defend myself anymore. Right. Blame me. And I don't want to be 2020 hindsight hypocrite here because I said last year I wasn't very impressed with Coach McAdoo last year. And I wasn't very impressed down the stretch last year with their offense because remember they were averaging 19 points a game,
right.
But they kept surviving. And then you got to go fix 19 points a game. And you got to fix it in the offensive line. And he didn't address
right.
a soul in the offensive line. They said, no, we'll come back intact. Really?
Yeah.
Okay. And I got to tell you, as much as I like Eli Manning personally, I'm seeing him starting to hit the wall. He's 37 going on 38 now? And I'm seeing a guy who's just, he's been banged around. Not that he's been hurt, but he's taken a lot of hits,
mm-hmm.
especially this year. And I'm not seeing the Eli who played at a much higher Pro Bowl-like level before. I think he's starting to hit the wall.
But would he not hit the wall if the offensive line was able to keep him in time?
And obviously now it's not fair because you lose your two receivers. You know,
And also, look, we talk about Eli. Look at the other quarterbacks in that class, right? Phillip Rivers, Ben Roethlisberger a couple weeks ago was talking about retiring.
He was?
You know, one of his personalities was, yeah. So, you know, it's
true.
It's the same. Yeah. Of course, they're not going to be at that same level. There's only one Tom Brady who just gets better as, you know, the days go on. Mm-hmm. But it's interesting. I think it's actually – easier to excel now later on in the NFL because the way the players come in nowadays, they all think like, I'm famous, I'm good. You know, they think famous for being great. And they just don't work as hard as guys like you did. And back in the day, you had to grind just to make the Pro Bowl. Now guys are blowing the Pro Bowl up, right? When he was playing, these guys would call all day long and be like, the biggest names, the Tony Gonzalez's and Urlacher's, did I make the Pro Bowl? Right? You knew you had, like, that was your path to greatness. Now guys are like, I'm an Instagram star.
I got a million followers. I got a million followers.
So it's actually easier, I think, to have this longevity now because you have this certain work ethic when you're from a different generation.
Yeah. Back to anonymous quotes. You've used them before. I've certainly used them before in my time as a journalist. And I don't know what your issue is with them.
I don't have a problem with it. I think they're good. They serve their purpose.
As long as they're accurate, I'm good.
They serve their purpose. And I'm pretty sure these anonymous quotes by ESPN, I'm pretty sure they're straight from the heart of how those two players,
correct.
As cowardly as they might be, perceive their situation right now.
And here's the thing. Guys talk at anger. No doubt.
Yeah.
Easy, right?
Yeah.
You have 53 dudes in there. Like I said, you can get anybody. I can go to 53 guys. We can get whatever kind of we want to, but is there frustration there? Absolutely.
Yeah.
1,000,000%. And even, look.
What, they got one win?
There's been great teams who get frustrated with their coach. There's any family. You spend more time with your coach than you actually do with your real family, mm-hmm. right? So any family, you go through issues, right? We go through different things where we need different therapists. They don't have therapists they can go to. They got to be each other's mm-hmm. therapists. That's why you have players-only meetings. That's what the therapy. That's why they have these team meetings where you try and lay it all on the line. They become each other's mental health experts, as crazy as that sounds.
I got it. Yeah. And in the end, I think the media deserves some blame for overrating this team and building expectations it could not live up to.
Because look at the defense. And do you think they got Brandon Marshall. They drafted Evan Ingram. And you're like, man, they're going to be the deal with.
Yeah. No running back, no offensive line.
Okay. That's it right there. Mm. The O-line.
Mm.
Well, be sure to check out Jay and the Fox NFL Sunday team from Naval Station Norfolk on Sunday. Jay, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, absolutely.
Veterans
Day, we're always
LeBron and the Cavs beat the Rockets tonight. We'll discuss that next.